ಆದಿಭ್ಯೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯ ಕರ್ತೃಭ್ಯೋ ವಂಶ ಋಷಭ್ಯೋ ಮಹದ್ಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ಗುರುಭ್ಯಃ ಸರ್ವೋಪಪ್ಲವರಹಿತ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಗಣ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಗರ್ಥೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಸೋಹಮಸ್ಮಿ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಮಸ್ಮಿ. ಓಂ ಪ್ರಪನ್ನ ಪಾರಿಜಾತಾಯ ತೋತ್ರ ವೇತ್ರೈಕ ಪಾಣಯೇ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಮುದ್ರಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ಗೀತಾಮೃತ ದುಹೇ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶಾಯ. My best wishes and Paripurna Ashirvadams to all the viewers of Sri Venkateshwara Bhakti Channel. May Lord Venkateshwara, the Almighty, bestow all kinds of katakshams and Paripurna Ashirvadams with prosperity to you and your entire family members. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 3, verse number 8. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. ನಿಯತಂ ಕುರು ಕರ್ಮ ತ್ವಂ ಕರ್ಮ ಜ್ಯಾಯೋ ಹ್ಯ ಕರ್ಮಣಃ ಶರೀರ ಯಾತ್ರಾಪಿ ಚ ತೇ ನ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧೇದ ಕರ್ಮಣಃ. ಭಗವಾನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅರ್ಜುನ, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬಿ ಎಂಡೌಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ಆಕ್ಷನ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎಂಡೌಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಇಂಟ್ರಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಡೀಪ್ಲಿ. Because the Karma Yoga began in the second, third words of this chapter. So we have seen five verses from Krishna. Among those five verses, in one verse, I suppose third verse, Sarva Prakriti Jair Gunaihi, he had introduced one force, that which is beyond everything, that which controls everything. But I have not brought the last sessions because we need to be interpreted, we need to be introduced slowly, otherwise, you know, it will be too much. Now, simply let us put in this way. Go and sit in a place, close your eyes, and just observe what is going on in your body. So, when you observe, breath is taking place, that is not in your control, blood circulations, liver functions and all intestine digestive systems, all organs, they are not waiting for your permission. Though you have food, you select food from outside, but when it goes inside, you cannot select. But this digestive system, they kept on working, they don't stop. Even heart, medical science says, in between the two beats, it gets the rest. Is it the rest? No. That keeps on working. It means what? There is a karma. There are karma. Because so many aspects, you know. So karma can be used as a singular. Okay. There is a karma, actions. It's always on. Okay. And the actions which you produce with an intention means when you want to achieve something, you make effort. If you want to reach the next room, then you go to, you have to get up and you have to walk to reach the place. That action and this action automatically which is on, both are not same. So willingly when you make with willful activity, that activity is different than these actions which is on. These actions beyond your control, beyond your hold, you cannot stop them, you cannot ask them to stop. They started functioning when we were born. When we were in the womb, we were connected with our mother's body. And when we were born, these lungs started functioning, then it has become individual machine or part of the universe. Now our body is the part of the universe. Then the actions of the body also part of the universe. Now Earth is rotating in its orbit. So I am giving same example so that you can connect with the philosophy. Not the philosophy, it's a fact. Because when I use the word of philosophy, people will also misunderstand this is not for us. Philosophy means what Bhagavad Gita gives, it's a fact, it's a truth. Whether you understand or not, we are trying to understand the karma, the secret of karma. Therefore, we have to be very thorough. We have the actions, and outside of this body, there are innumerable actions. They have their own sequence, their own organizing method. They function properly. Sun rises. May it not sunrise us, earth rotates regularly on a time. These all functions controlled by, functioned by whom? There must be some power. And when I want to perform, this body should help and the environment also should help for me. Otherwise, I cannot produce any action. If I want to get up here, we can get up immediately. We set the thought. See, I want to get up. I want to take this. I want to drop this. The same sankalpa, if you get it done in the moon or somewhere else, you cannot do because outside environment won't help. So this system which is called creation is created by whom? They call it Prakriti. Prakriti means what? It's a name in order to refer a power by which everything comes into manifestation. You don't think Prakriti means sitting with a sword, sitting with some weapon, no. Or which is like a demon or some kind of potential capacity. It's a Prakriti. Prakriti means that which brings everything into name and form, into being. Okay? Now the action which we produce is because of what? Same Prakriti. Now the difference between animal and us, the difference between the action of the inert material, the mountain looks as though it is standing, but when you see the mountain from the moon, the mountain also is rotating with the earth. It means what? Karmamayam jagat, this all actions, activities, it is governed by the energy. When you look at any object, you are getting thought. When I bring a rose in front of you, you should have the thought of rose. You should have the vritti. Vritti means what? A thought. When I bring something else, when I bring an apple, you should have the apple thought. It's a karma. So never ever your mind wait you to give the permission to bring thought. Never. It takes place immediately. That's a magical creation. So now you should be or you will be amazed by understanding. It seems to be everything is out of our control. No, but everything is according to our karma phala. Everything is according to our karma phala. That is the secret. If everything is according to my karma phala, what about my heartbeat? Yes, your heartbeat will function according to your karma phala. So when it is to begin, when it is to get an end, it is fixed already by the actions which I produce. Now already karma phala, which seems to be out of my control, it was created by me alone. Now as though it seems to be out of my control. But the work which I produce voluntarily now, when I speak, when I look at something, when I get the thought, when I express anything in the form of action, will be the cause of future function of the body. My face is because of my past action. My height and weight and color and everything is because of my past action, willful action. Therefore, I have to be careful what? The action which I produce. That's what Krishna says here, Arjuna, you have to be very careful when you produce your action. See, the all action, even sun rising, earth rotating, and all these oceans are going up as a cloud and coming as a rain, getting into river and bringing like a plant. Everything is according to your past action. Now you become the author of the world. You become the author of your world which is created. And is there any world outside of my karma pala? No. How would it be possible? Because everybody should have the karma pala. We will discuss that later. Every one of us have their own world, that we will discuss later. But you understand, the world is nothing but the expansion of your karma phala. Your body is nothing but the expansion of your past karma phala. Then the karma which I produce now, I have to be careful, because it will come in future as my face. Because the face is, you know, replaced. So now he says, when you produce your karma phala, don't produce like an animal. Animal is driven by instincts. When animal feels thirsty, then it will run and it will pluck. Anybody has the water, doesn't matter. It will pluck and it will drink, it will pluck and it will eat if it is hunger. Don't do it. And not only that, when it feels fear by somebody, it will kill. You're not like that. You are a human being. You should not be driven by your instinct, because the system which is called body is as equal to animal alone. Sometimes animals are stronger than us. An elephant is stronger than us. Physically they are more stronger. Memory wise they are more stronger. A dog has got stronger smelling capacity. A cat has got a listening capacity. A snake has got the fast moving capacity. Then what is that we have as a special power, as a special thing? That sixth sense, so called by the scientist, is the only thing by which you can inquire. But you can produce the action which will produce punya, that welfare to you, to the entire universe. That kind of action you should produce. When you produce that kind of action, you are called contributor. If you are bringing the actions out as an animal, you will be called as a consumer. When we want to destruct, we want to get something, in order to get something, we destroy so many things. What is the difference between animals and us? Then what karma can be suitable for us as a human being? What karma should I take? Those karmas are unfolded by Vedas, categorized in five ways. We have already seen those five names of the karma, but we have not seen in detail. Those karmas are called Nitya Karma, Naimattika Karma, Prayaschitta Karma, Kamya Karma, then Nishiddha Karma. These five categories, I have specified the five categories which is produced as the willful action. And those actions will be producing future of my life, future of my world, and future of the universe. Therefore, what I have to be very careful. Arjuna, you have to be aware about these five actions. And five actions means, how do we categorize it? Don't worry, already it has been given categorically by our forefathers. What is Nitya Karma? Nitya means regular, that which is performed in regular basis. So when you perform regularly, that can be called as a Nitya Karma. No, regularly means So certain karmas which are unfolded by Vedas like Sandhya Vandana, Samhita Dana, not only that, the going to the temple and having done some kind of ceremonies are called Nitya Karma. To be done regularly. See, if you are doing regularly watching movie, cannot be a Nitya Karma. That Nitya Karma, you are driven by your instinct. Your instinct means, so when you listen to the music, your ears, they feel good. When you get some smell agarbatti, your nose feels good. Means mind feels good through nose. Don't let your mind in that way. Whether you like or not, Nitya Karma, you have to get up by 5:30 early in the morning. It's a Nitya Karma. It is suggested, unfolded by Vedas. And Sandhya Vandana, Samhita Dana, going to the temple and having worship, it is described according to Varna Ashrama Dharma. If you are a Brahmana, your Nitya Karma is different than the Kshatriya's Nitya Karma. But every cadre has their own Nitya Karma. That's what Varna Ashrama Dharma. So Brahmana has his own Nitya Karma. Kshatriya has his own Nitya Karma. Vaishya has his own Nitya Karma. Shudra has his own Nitya Karma. And nobody is superior, nobody is inferior. Those Nitya Karma, Niyatam Karma Kuru. The Karma Kuru means you have to perform the action. And that action not like an animal, not like an inert object, not like a demon. You have to act like a human being who is very responsible enough. That has to be considered by the Shastra, governed by Shastra. Tasmat Shastram Pramanam Te Karya Karya Vyavasthitau. The last verse of this chapter, he will define whatever the karma you do, it has to be governed by Shastra. So many secrets he is going to unfold. Niyatam karma means prescribed actions. You should perform the action which are prescribed. That's what I am telling now. So that prescribed action, there are 5 categories. Nitya karma to be done regularly. Naimittika karma like Amavasya, Tarpana, Shraddha, and not only that, according to the ages, Jata karma, Namakarna, Pumsamana, all these up to Shraddha, those are based on Nitya, therefore it is called Naimittika karma. This both Nitya and Naimittika karma, watch carefully. Both Nitya and Naimittika karma, when you perform, there is no fruit. You won't get punya. My God. You won't get punya means, is it win? No. When you are not performing these two, you will be affected by a papa. It's a unique calculation by our forefather. Don't ask how. These are all not physics or chemistry. It's H2O. We cannot say that. This is accepted by Vedas. When you perform Nitya Karma and Naimittika Karma, you won't get Punya Phala. But when you are not performing, you will be affected by Papa. Then immediately you should not say that the spiritual is dogma. It is threatening us. It's not to threaten. When you got a human body, that human body should give something to the society. So human means you have the responsibility to take care of the surrounding being, the nature, so that we have been given the sixth sense. They have found the actions adrishta based. These actions are based on adrishta. Adrishta means that which cannot be seen, that which cannot be given a proof. This Nitya Naimittika Karma, when you perform, you are establishing the universe. Those karmas will help the universal dharma to be established. This universal dharma will be the path by your karma, nitya and naimittika. And prayaschitta karma means it's a neutralizing karma. When you miss to perform this nitya and naimittika, then you can get it done prayaschitta. And foremost is nishiddha karma. Nishiddha karma means the karma to be avoided. You should not get it done. Those karmas animal may do. Killing somebody for the sake of food. Cheating somebody for the survival. So life is not only survival. Because animals, the intention is to survive. The human intention is not like that. We are beyond that. We have to become a contributor for the society. For the society means not only for human being, not only for animals, not only for birds, so for creation. That's what the intelligent job. So we have to stop, we have to avoid first what to be avoided. That is the first condition. Then we have to adopt this nitya karma and naimittika karma. So after that it comes nitya karma, naimittika karma, prayaschitta karma. Then finally kamya karma. Kamya karma means desired object can be made for effort. You can make effort for your desired object. Veda gives in the form of rituals, in the form of your own effort, earn money for name or fame or whatever the effort you can make. Therefore he says these five karma must be followed by every human being. This is an invention, beautiful, spectacular, marvelous invention by our rishis. If anybody wants to have the research on it, do PhD on that, so they can just begin that. These adrushtas are very valuable inventions. He says, Arjuna, be endowed with your karma. Whether nitya karma, naimittika karma, kshatriya and kamya karma, you just follow. But you have to change your attitude, not like before. Not like before means what? Not like before the teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Then what kind of attitude I should set now? That's what he brings in the next shloka. Before that, in this shloka he says, you have to perform the karma, no chance. Don't be interested in a karma, in action, to give up all the responsibility, to go somewhere else. No, your world will be waiting there to bug you. Wherever you go, it will bug. Therefore, what better you work. If you drop the action, even your body also won't be taken care of. Your body needs your actions. You have to give food. You have to give workout. You have to give job to your mind. Mind is the devil. Therefore it is said, idle mind is devil's workshop. Don't allow it. But we have to work. The attitude must be changed. This is the game changing, means life changing teaching. As I told you in the first chapter and the second chapter too, this karma phala which is produced not because of karma, because of the attitude. That attitude, he says, yajna bhava. The name of the attitude is called yajna bhava. Let me repeat once again, yajna bhava. That's what he brings. Yajnyartha karmanon yatra lokoyam karma bandhanaha tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sangasam achara. You have to perform, Arjuna, with this attitude. Yajna bhava. Now Arjuna had not heard before. And I said, what is yajna bhava? I know yajna. Yajna means fire rituals. Okay. So what is bhava in it? Is there a peculiar, like a product? Then he says, this yajna bhava will help you to convert a karma into a magic. Okay. That's a matter. So what the benefit I will get out of it? Because it will protect you from bondage. Oh, it seems to be good. Ayam lokaha karma bandhanaha. If you are not bringing this proper attitude with karma, but karma will take you. It won't allow you to be happy. It won't allow you to be relaxed. It will be driving. That's what already you are doing. You cannot keep yourself quiet. You take off for a week in order to take rest. You see that whole week will be driven by you. So, andar jo baita hai na, the aadmi, the person who is sitting inside, he will drive you like anything. Therefore, be endowed with a proper job. And that job too, now you are going to fight, you are going to fight with a different attitude, my dear. That attitude means that bhavana which bring magical results. Yajnyarthat karmanaha anyatra, whereas ayam lokaha karma bandhanaha. This earth, wherever you go, every object is very attractive because they have karma phala. It will swallow you, it will collapse you. But if you have a proper attitude called Ajna Bhava, you will be protected and you can also protect others. That's the magic. Okay, I don't know what is Ajna Bhava. So now we have learnt, whatever you do, that has to be governed by this five karma. Nitya karma, Naimittika karma, Prayashchitta karma, Kamya karma, and the final one is Nishiddha karma. Nishiddha karma means prohibited work, prohibited action. Kamya karma means a desired object. So you can make effort whatever you wish. That has to be governed by the Vedas. Now you may ask the questions, where I will get this knowledge? Just read Puranas, Itihasas, you will understand what to be done. Don't get confused. Don't be carried away by so many other aspects. Just you live your life, you earn money, you help your family, but when you read Puranas and Itihasas, you know, automatically your transformation will take place. And complete Bhagavad Gita, of course. Bhagavad Gita will help. Slowly you will transform yourself. You can see the magic. Okay. Now, these five karmas must be performed with Yajna Bhava. Therefore, this is called Mukta Sangha Samacharaha. You can survive with a liberated mind, with a detached mind, as a free person. Even though you can do lots of karma, this is the point. After taking sannyasa, even many sannyasis are endowed with lots of institutions. They create schools and colleges and so many annakshatras and so many factories even they run. It seems to be they are none other than like a businessman. No. So inside they are endowed with a different attitude, bhavana. Now Arjuna is totally confused because he knows Yajna what it is. He even doesn't know what Yajna is. Do you know what the fire ritual? Yes, we know, of course. Because offering fire, offering something in the fire, it's called fire rituals. No. Fire rituals also is a magic. So when you offer something in the fire, how you get benefit? Whether you get benefit or not, because many people they don't believe. When I put fire, everything goes vain. Because when I want to earn money, I have to make effort. That effort, by that effort, I get money. But when I pour it, when I offer in the fire, I could see something, you know, I am losing something. No, you are given. You will be given definitely. How? There is a science. There is a chemistry. There is a process. When you offer, that fire absorbs it and after that it sends towards the sky. That we will continue in the next session. The next will be the science of yajna, the secret of yajna. Because in order to know what yajna bhavana, we have to know what is yajna. Because the yajna is adrishta karya. So when you understand yajna, then you can understand what is yajna bhavana. That we will see in the next session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.